Hey guys, welcome back to Illness Scripts Pencast. Today we are going to create an illness script for temporal arteritis, also known as giant cell arteritis. For reasons that we'll discuss, this disease falls into the category of frequently tested topics because it has classic red flags and requires prompt onset of treatment before diagnosis is confirmed to prevent significant morbidity. In other words, this is the perfect test question for medicine boards. Predisposing factors for temporal arteritis include age, as this is most often seen in patients over the age of 70 and almost never seen in patients less than 50 years old. Temporal arteritis is also far more common in men than in women. Lastly, temporal arteritis is more common in Caucasians or those of Northern European descent and much less common in African Americans or in Asian patients. I'll also mention that temporal arteritis is frequently associated with polymyalgia rheumatica, or PMR. PMR precedes the onset of temporal arteritis, or it may even follow it. This association is extremely important, and the boards love to test it. Patients will endorse nonspecific symptoms of fatigue and possibly low-grade fever. The classic symptom is unilateral temporal headache that is significantly worse on palpation and often associated with jaw claudication. Visual changes, or even loss, is the dreaded complication of temporal arteritis and changes the management of these patients from PO steroids to admission to the hospital for IV steroids. Frankly, it is this complication alone which makes this topic a frequent boards question, so it's very important to know. Lastly, patients may also have proximal muscle pain and/or stiffness, as this is an indication of concurrent PMR. This is a good time to compare temporal arteritis to a possible distracting differential diagnosis, migraine headaches. Unfortunately, migraine headaches are also more common in women, are unilateral, and also can be located over the temporal region. Furthermore, visual symptoms may also be present as part of an aura. However, new onset of migraine headaches is exceedingly rare in those over the age of 50. Remember that temporal arteritis is almost never seen below this age. Also, you would not expect headache to worsen with palpation over the temporal artery in migraine headaches. Exam findings for temporal arteritis are only really notable for tenderness to palpation over the temporal artery, or some other abnormality such as a beaded contour when palpating the temporal artery. Lab findings are not very specific for temporal arteritis, but the key labs to focus on are ESR and CRP, as they have an incredible sensitivity for this disease. The definitive test for temporal arteritis is temporal artery biopsy. It is incredibly important, however, that if suspicion is high for temporal arteritis, then empiric steroids are started prior to sending the patient for this biopsy. Failure to do so is malpractice. Thus, an illness script for temporal arteritis could read, a 78-year-old woman with a history of polymyalgia rheumatica presents with new-onset left-sided temporal headache associated with jaw claudication, with worsening pain on palpation, with markedly elevated ESR and CRP. Temporal artery biopsy is notable for inflammation of the arterial wall. Thanks again for watching. Please remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel to get future videos. Leave a comment with future topics you want to see covered that can help you either on the boards or on the wards. Until next time.